stand to be alone.
Try.
This long distance has us living on the phone.
What if your child get ammonia?
Ever since you've been away, I just can't get through a day. Girl, I just can't wait to have you here at home. Oh, baby, every time.
What's going on, everybody? Welcome, 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 welcome to another episode of the Mack Lessons Radio Show. And my name, I am Mr. Tariq Elite, also known as King Flex, also known as Tariq Nasheed. Glad to have everybody tuning into the show. Today's show is brought to you by headhuntersgear.com. Get busy hustling or get busy dying. Get your gear on, t-shirts, all your fashion accessories at headhuntersgear.com. And also, you can step your financial game up at blackguidetomoney.com. You want to stack your paper up? You want to learn how to get your dividends up, get your money right? Go to blackguidetomoney.com. And today is also brought to you by Hidden Colors Film, HiddenColorsFilm.com. Check out the critically acclaimed documentary Hidden Colors at HiddenColorsFilm.com, ladies and gentlemen. And we're working on Hidden Colors 2 as we speak. A lot of people have been asking about Hidden Colors 2. We're working on that as we speak. Now, this Sunday, I might have on my Ustream show a first look trailer, a world premiere of the trailer to Hidden Colors 2. We might have that ready Sunday for Ustream. So I would advise everybody to follow me on Ustream or follow me on Twitter, and then I can let you know when we do the Ustream show. But we do the Ustream show on Sunday nights. So if I premiere the Hidden Colors trailer this Sunday, it would be Sunday night, 7 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. So spread the word, let everybody know that they should tune in, because we're working on getting the trailer ready by Sunday. My people are working on it now, so you'll get to see, you'll be the first in the world to see what Hidden Colors 2 is going to look like, ladies and gentlemen. And it is a beast, I promise you that. Now, also, I'd like to apologize, ladies and gentlemen. I'm doing the show a day later. I'm in Hawaii right now, by the way. I'm broadcasting live from Hawaii. I'm in Honolulu right now. And I was so busy yesterday. We do the show on Wednesday, and I was running around getting editing done and just all over town and getting my flights and all that stuff popping. I've been all over the place, so I didn't get a chance to do the show yesterday. And when I got to Hawaii, I left computer adapters and stuff at home in LA. Then I had to go get a bunch of stuff out here. So it was a whole bunch of technical worldwide shit going on. But I'm here, ladies and gentlemen, and I apologize for doing the show a day later, but we're going to chop up some good game and make it do what it do. Let me put on some nice Mackin music so I can chop up game with all the players and playettes. Shout out to all the wonderful brothers and sisters I met at the airport on my way over. I met some real good people at the airport who love Hidden Colors. People are just loving Hidden Colors all around the world, and I can't wait till you guys see Hidden Colors 2. That's going to really change the game. But I digress, ladies and gentlemen. So today's show is going to be a fun show. Later on in the show, I'm going to give 10 brand new player rules for summer 2012. The summertime is coming, so it's about that time that I laid out some new player rules so all my players can abide by the game, respect the game, and live up to the game. Now, before I get into that, let me play a real funny clip that I played on Ustream this weekend, and a lot of people have been asking about it. There's this clip of this guy. He's a rapper named Krispy Kreme. He's a white kid from Alabama, and he has a lot of videos on YouTube. And this one particular video, the guy seems like he's a little off or something. I don't know what's going on with the guy. He's like a white version of this rapper named 50 Tyson. There's this brother named 50 Tyson. He's a rapper, and he's kind of slow. I don't know if he has autism, something. He's kind of off, and he'd be rapping, then he'll forget what he's rapping about. He's just real off. So now there's a white version of that. This dude named Krispy Kreme. And the guy Krispy Kreme, the name is a beast. he made a video talking about how people should follow their dreams. And in the middle of the video of him talking, he just busts out crying. He just breaks down crying for really no reason. And then he stops crying like nothing happened. So it was a real strange video. And the guy is dead serious, by the way. This guy is dead ass serious. And he's from Alabama. So when he talks, you can kind of hear a redneck vibe. But the guy, he seems like a cool guy. But I'm going to play the clip of Krispy Kreme giving some positive motivation to the YouTube fans. And he's talking about living up to your dreams and following your dreams. And again, right in the middle of him talking, he busts out. He kind of starts breaking down, and you can hear him fighting off the tears while he's talking. So here's the clip.
Don't ever give up on your dreams. I'm talking about dreams that you really have, okay? Because if you lay down at night and you dream about these goals that you want to accomplish, and you have to be willing to sacrifice for everything that you want, okay? While your friends out...
That's another thing. He always says, okay, after everything. Sacrifice what you like for, okay? And that's funny as hell.
Are out, like, drinking and partying and stuff. You have to be at home, alone, focused on your goals. Do you understand that? Because the only thing that's ever going to stop you from achieving your dreams is yourself and the people around you. So, if you got goals that you want, Chief, okay... You don't ever give up.
He's fighting off the tears.
Because I was at a point in my life where I didn't think I was ever going to accomplish my dreams. Okay? And I never give up on my dreams. Okay? And I always just fought for what I wanted. While all my friends were out having fun, okay? While all my friends were out having fun, I was always at home alone. Working towards my dreams, okay? And I know there's other kids out there who are in the same situation that I was, who have dreams and goals that they want to accomplish, and they feel like they're not getting there, okay? You got those dreams and those goals. Don't let anybody get in the way of what you're trying to do, okay? Because I promise you that if you work with all of your heart towards those goals, okay, and then if you scrape and you crawl towards those goals, and you never give up, ever, I promise you that you're going to achieve all of your dreams, okay? And please, all you kids out there, just stay away from drugs and alcohol and all that other junk.
He's throwing in all types of messages. He's like, stay away from drugs. Keep up with your dreams. He's throwing in every message he can think of.
Okay, because it's only going to ruin your life. And make sure you don't get no girl pregnant before you're ready to take care of a child, okay? Because there's so much stuff that goes on in the world that just gets in the way of your dreams, and I don't want that to ever happen.
He said don't get a girl pregnant.
So if you got goals and you got dreams, you buckle down, okay? You buckle down, you don't drink, you don't do drugs. You don't go out there and have sex with all kinds of girls, okay? You find a girl that you love and you take care of her. And I promise that every one of your dreams are going to come true.
Now he didn't stop crying.
But you have to sacrifice for them, okay?
Now he didn't stop crying now.
Okay? When you're weak and you're beaten down, you have to sacrifice for your dreams. And I promise you that if you put all of your mental energy and your physical energy and everything you got towards your goals... And they're real goals, okay? I'm talking about, they gotta be goals that you...
Now he's talking normal. So this motherfucker's just talking. Everything was cool. Then all of a sudden his ass just busts out crying. That was just real weird. And what he was saying was a good message. But why did this motherfucker just start crying? So that's hilarious. So you can see that on YouTube. The guy's name is Krispy Kreme. So I played the clip of that. The visual of that is hilarious. I played it on Ustream Sunday. And a lot of people have been requesting that. So I had to play that for the players. And again, you guys follow me on Twitter at Tariq Nasheed, and I'll let you know what time we're doing the Ustream show. And I can give you the link to the Ustream show. On Ustream, for some reason, when you type in my name or type in my show, they don't have me in the search engine over there at Ustream. And my show is one of the most popular shows over there, so I don't know what's going on, and I done hollered at them about it. So the best way to follow me on Ustream is follow me on Twitter, and I give you the updates. So follow me on Twitter at Tariq Nasheed. If you don't know how to spell Tariq Nasheed, take your ass and get a GED. You should know how to spell my name by now. But I digress. Now let's get into some game, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get into some ism. Let's get into some game. So everybody grab your pens and grab your paper. We're going to talk about 10 new player rules for the summertime of 2012. So we're going to get this game popping. Let's get the game popping right about now. Now, rule number one, fellas, rule number one for the summer of 2012, date out of your league. I want you players to start dating women who seem to be out of your league. You're going to have to upgrade your game. And if you think a woman is out of your league, if you think she's too good for you, that's the main one you should be dating. If you want to tackle fear, because a lot of guys, you guys have a fear of women. A lot of guys have a fear of attractive women too. The more attractive a woman is in many cases, the more a guy fears her because a guy feels that she is out of his league. And what psychiatrists and psychologists do to people who have a fear of something, they make them confront that fear. That's the only way to get over that fear. If a person has a fear, and we're talking about an unwarranted fear. I'm not talking about like a fear of heights, which is a natural fear to have. Every mammal basically has a fear of heights to a certain degree. But even you can overcome that. That's why we have base jumpers and mountain jumpers and bungee jumpers and all that stuff. But certain fears of certain things, it's just a natural instinct for survival protection. But I'm talking about unwarranted fear of certain things. Like there are people who have a fear of butterflies. You've seen these shows where people on here crying, they're on TV crying because they fear, they have a fear of pickles. Just some real dumb shit. Y'all remember Tyra Banks was talking about she has a fear of dolphins. It was some dumb shit. Tyra had a fear of goddamn dolphins. Real crazy shit. But a lot of guys, man, you guys have a fear of women, and the best way to confront, or to get over the fear, is to confront what you're afraid of and challenge what you're afraid of. So you got to start stepping to women, fellas, who are seemingly out of your league. If you see a woman who's a dime, you think that she's dating a rapper, you think she's dating a drug dealer, you think that you ain't on her level, immediately start spitting at her. Confront that fear and spit some nice regular game like you're spitting at all the other females. And that's going to help alleviate the fear you have. You're going to see that that dime is not going to bite you. And if you step to one of these women who seem like they're out of your league, that's going to really calm your game down when it comes to all these other females, especially these lackluster females that a lot of you dudes be cupcaking with. A lot of you dudes start cupcaking with these lackluster females, and these lackluster females are really chipping away at your self-esteem, making it seem like they're out of your league. These lackluster females oftentimes make it seem like they're doing you a favor by dating you, and that fucks with your self-esteem. But when you get used to dating dimes, women who are out of your league seemingly, you'll realize that they're not out of your league, and you'll know that when you date an average woman, or if you choose to deal with an average woman, she's not doing you a favor. You're doing her a favor, and if you'll have that psychological advantage. So it's very important, fellas, that you date out of your league or seemingly out of your league. I don't give a damn what kind of money you have. Nigga, you can have a raggedy Pinto or whatever kind of car. And you spit to whoever. Don't wait until you get your money right. Don't wait until you get your record deal. Just start spitting. Just to get out there in the game if you're out there in the dating arena as it is. Because truth be told, there's never a right time to get out there start spitting. Now, if you're insecure about certain things, there's a lot of guys who might be insecure about their living situation or their job situation. That's understandable. But if you're out there in the dating arena anyway, I say be extremely bold and just start going for the gusto and start dating out of your league, seemingly out of your league. Now, let's move on to rule number two. For summer rules for the players 2012. Now, rule number two, fellas, and I've talked about this before on my show, you have to take responsibility for everything that happens with your game, good or bad. You got to take responsibility for what happens. If a female puts you in a trick bag, it's your fault. If a female looks at you as a simp, it is your fault, fellas. Because the thing is, you allowed that dynamic to be created within the relationship. You understand? People will put you in the kind of bag you allow them to put you in. If females are, excuse me, if females are stepping to you like a simp, that means you've given off some kind of energy, or you must have misstepped your game and created that simp energy for the woman to put you into that simp category. Now, the thing is, there are some women who might test you, but the thing is, if you're already in a trick bag or a simp bag, or you're in a situation where you ain't getting no ass and you've been hanging around a woman for 6-7 months, that's your fault, player. So don't give off this angry, passive-aggressive energy with a lot of these women when you don't get what you want or you're upset about the dynamic you're in the relationship, because it ain't her fault. Women are usually followers. They will do what dudes allow them to do. You understand that? So always take responsibility for your game, fellas. That's a very important rule. Now, let's go to a fashion rule. Now, this is rule number 3. Let's get into fashion a little bit, because a lot of cats always ask me about fashion. Now, rule number 3, we're going to wear some loose pants this summer, because it's beyond the skinny jeans. Now, dudes, I done talked about the skinny jeans a million times. Now, niggas are wearing skinny shorts. Niggas are going to the beach and out in the streets and coochie cutters and shit. And some of these pants are too goddamn tight. I don't care what the trend is. Fellas, you set the trend. You understand what I'm saying? Get these goddamn tight pants off. If a motherfucker can see what's in your damn pockets, your pants are too tight. Nigga can look at you and tell you got a chapstick and 75 cent in your fucking pocket. Loosen up them damn pants and keep it Mackish. I don't give a damn what the trend is. I don't care what rapper wore what in the video. Don't you wear them tight ass pants. On a subconscious level, women look real funny style at that shit. Now, let's get to rule number 4, ladies and gentlemen. Now, rule number 4 is really about a code between you and your players. Rule number 4 is about a code between you and your group, you and your crew, you and the dudes that you roll with. Because I always talk about how important it is for the players to have a code within themselves. And there's a general universal man code. There's a player code that guys should have. And code rule number 4 is a very important one. Number 4, if your partner's significant other steps to you for information about your partner, you don't know shit. That should be a given. That should be a given. But now we have so many chatty ass niggas, talkative ass dudes, dry snitching ass dudes. Y'all don't know when to shut up when your homie's baby mama call you, when his wife calls you, when his girlfriend calls you, whatever. As a rule, you never, ever, ever give out any information about your dude, your homie. If his mom or his baby mama calls up, or his wife calls up and say, hey, have you seen, was James with you last night at the club? You gotta say 3 things. I don't know. I don't remember. I have to call you back because I'm busy. That's what you're supposed to say. You're supposed to play that shit off. You're not supposed to give any information that's going to be used against your partner. And a lot of guys these days, they violate that rule. You never give out any information about your partners. And I've had some of my homies, ladies, call me trying to ask little slick questions to crowbar information. I don't know shit. You're not getting shit up out of me. I almost act like I don't even know the nigga she talking about. Like, who? You know, Kevin, your best friend. Oh, that Kevin. Oh, I don't know. I don't know. You know, I got some in the oven. I got to call you back. Don't answer shit. Play that to the left and you keep it pushing. Let that go between them, because you don't want them tossing your name in the mix. When they get to arguing, you don't want nobody name dropping, because the female will start dropping your name heavy. Well, Tariq said that you was at the strip club. I mean, they'll throw your name out there in the mix at the drop of a hat. So don't even allow that to happen. Don't give them nothing to go with. And that should be a given. Now, let's go on to rule number 5, Player Rule 2012. And I talked about this on this week's Ustream show. This is a rule about appearance. Fellas, for summer 2012, keep your dental game up. I've been running into a lot of cats out here in the streets all around the country. A lot of these brothers, man, a lot of brothers' dental game is not up to par. Niggas' teeth are looking a beast right now. You can't really be on top of your game and your teeth ain't right. Your teeth are very important, man. Now, I know a lot of times cats grew up, the mom didn't have a dental plan or whatever, but as you get older, man, you can get your goddamn mouth fixed. The way your teeth look says a lot about you. People will prejudge you. And I've seen a lot of good people with good hearts, good information, but their teeth just look like a bag of damn white Skittles, just all jumbled up in their goddamn mouth. You got to have your dental game together, because people respect motherfuckers who have their mouth right. There's a respectability that goes there. If you let your teeth go, people can't really trust you. You understand? This is a subconscious thing. If your teeth are jacked up, people can't really trust the motherfucker whose mouth is toe up. They're looking at you like, nigga, if you didn't do right by your teeth, you can't do right by me. You understand what I'm saying? Get your mouth right. And it's not even about a money thing. A lot of cats just don't put value in getting their dental game up, because they'll get the money. That's why you have a lot of rappers. You have rappers, niggas in Bentleys, and you popping bottles, and your teeth look like a bunch of tombstones in your mouth. And a lot of rappers, they'll get money and then put gold and platinum grills over the raggedy teeth. So your mouth just looks like a fucking dishwasher. Just silver plates and all types of shit just scattered all over the place. So if you got the money for some gold grills or some platinum grills, use that money to get some damn Invisaligns. Use that shit to get some caps over your teeth. Get your teeth together. Get your tooth game up if you want to spit some hot fire in 2012, because that's what women like. Women look at a dude's teeth. Fly women. Women look at a nigga's teeth. They want a motherfucker whose teeth are right. Get your teeth right, fellas. Now, let's go into rule number 6. Rule number 6, player rule for summer 2012. Fellas, when you meet a woman, don't get too freaky too soon. A lot of you guys are doing that. Don't get too freaky too soon. Fellas, some of you dudes, man, you go on one date with a woman, you want to eat her out, lick her asshole in the car. You trying to do anything right when you meet a female, because that reeks of desperation. You don't want to be all thirsty acting and desperate acting. And women don't really respect a motherfucker who's licking her asshole and all that old shit right when you meet her. That's just not a good look. So let's calm down on the thirst. Calm down on the freakiness. Save some freaky shit for later on. Calm down, fellas. Don't give off that thirsty energy, that thirsty vibe when you hollering at women. Now let's get to rule number 7. Rule number 7. No twimping. That's a new term I came up with. No twimping. That's T-W-I-M-P-I-N-G. No twimping. You know what twimping is? That's simping on Twitter. A lot of you dudes will get on Twitter and you'll start simping with these females that you don't even know. Every time a female on Twitter posts up a picture of Instagram or a picture of herself looking sexy or whatever, she gets a bunch of replies from thirsty niggas, brown nosing, cupcaking, offering money, offering to take her on dates. Niggas are kissing ass and brown nosing on Twitter, and that's the saddest shit ever. Because you're simping, twimping, as I call it, is out there public in the world. Your twimping is now Googleable. You can Google this shit, and it's out there forever. So you don't want to put that twimping energy out there. Stop twimping And stop Facebook simping too, because a lot of niggas do some simping on Facebook. Whenever females put up a picture, you niggas out here cupcaking, brown nosing like you ain't never seen a female before. And that's why these women do it. They put up these pictures and all that because they know that thirsty niggas will give them the attention they so desperately need. You understand that? And stop catering to these attention-whoring females. Now, let's get to rule number 8. Now, rule number 8, summer 2012, fellas, what we're going to have to start doing is compounding your paper. You're going to have to compound your money, stack your paper up. This is very important. Popping bottles and tricking off your money is not the move, fellas. You're going to have to stack money up, and what you're going to have to do, put like a $25 to $30 on a bond. Just put some money away in an account that you don't really dip into. And just let your money stack up. One of my partners who's going to be on the show pretty soon, a brother named Daniel Freeman. He has a book called Making a Dollar Out of 15 Cent. And we're going to have him on the show pretty soon. He has a good book. And you guys can check his book out. I think you can get it on Amazon. How to Make a Dollar Out of 15 Cent by Daniel Freeman. And the brother talks about how to stack your money up in a very matter-of-fact, casual way. And what fellas are going to have to do, put some of your check, whatever money you get every week, put just a nice little percentage of it in a checking account, a bond, a CD, somewhere, and just let it stack up. Don't touch it. Don't even look at it, because when you look at it and you see how much money you have, a lot of times that'll start burning a hole in your pocket. So you want to put money somewhere where you can't see it. You just know that it's growing. Put it in an account somewhere. You ain't even looking at the receipt when you get it. Just keep stacking it, keep stacking it, keep stacking it. And even get gold if you have to. Get some gold bars and just let them sit. Get some money invested where you don't have to touch the money and just let it grow, let it grow, let it grow. And this is going to help your game. And I'm telling you how this is going to help your game. When you know, when you're out there spitting, you're spitting hot fire, you're at the clubs, you're at the bars, you're out there campaigning. And you know that you have a nice chunk of change stacked up somewhere. There's a calm that brings. There's a certain level of confidence that brings to you. That brings a certain level of security to you. That's why when you see very wealthy people out and about, I mean real wealthy people, people who have a lot of money, a lot of times they're just real low key with it. They have on casual clothes. I've talked about this before. I've hung out with cats who look extremely casual and they sitting on $50, $60 million because they have no need to floss. There's a comfortable vibe that they have. They don't need to go out here and show out because they know they're sitting on a nice chunk of paper, and that brings a certain level of confidence and a non-thirsty energy, and that energy attracts women. See, it's broke motherfuckers who's always fronting and flossing. Motherfucker done got all the gold on and got 80 cell phones and shit, and he's at the club. That's the motherfucker who ain't got nothing but $20, $30 saved up. That's one of them $300 drug dealers. Niggas who ain't really got no money, so they have to have a need to floss to appear to have more money than they have. That's insecurity. But again, when you know you got money stacked up, that's going to bring a calm to your game, because that's one of the biggest insecurities a lot of men have when it comes to getting out here dating. A lot of guys are insecure about their money situation. Now, the people at the club don't know this. When you're out at the bar and all this, they don't know about your money situation, but the energy you give off, because you know your money situation, it's a negative energy. And women feed off your energy. So if you give off a confident, calm, self-assured energy, the women are going to respond the same way. You understand that? So it's always best to alleviate any kind of insecurity you have. And usually a man's insecurity is about his finances. So if you know you got finances stacked up and you're good and you ain't going to be broke for a while, that's going to help your game. I promise you that. Now, the next rule, rule number 9, this is for players that are actually getting into relationships with women for the first time. Rule number 9, fellas, summer 2012, we're going to have zero power struggles with women. No power struggles, none. We're going to nip shit in the bud. especially when you meet a woman. This is especially true when you just meet a female. A lot of times when you meet a female, they want to get into a power struggle with you. They want to see how much they can get away with. They want to test you constantly. You have to nip that in the bud immediately. We're not going to do the power struggle thing. You're going to have to establish how you get down from Jump Street. I don't want you dudes emailing me 2 and 3 years later talking about your wife is talking to you fucked up, your lady is talking to you sideways. That's because you sat up and let her. You let that dynamic come into play. I don't want to hear about how your chick is controlling you. You again, let's go back to the rule from earlier. That's rule number three. It's no, actually rule number two. It's your fault. But the thing is, we're going to have zero power struggles. If a female starts challenging your authority, you're going to have to let her know two things. Number one, we ain't having no power struggle. I'm not going to go back and forth with you. You're going to have to respect what I'm bringing to this table right now and just let it be. Or you're going to have to bounce. It's going to be one of the goddamn two. And fellas, don't be scared to charge a woman to the game. Some of you fellas are so desperate for women, you feel like you have to hold on to any woman who comes your way and gives you play, and you have to take any kind of verbal abuse or any kind of verbal or emotional disrespect just because you don't want to lose a chance to get some ass. Fellas, there's more than one female out there, and there's going to always be more than one female out there. So check these women and let her know it's either your way or the dough way. You understand what I'm saying? Stop playing games with them. No power struggles for summer 2012. All right. And the last rule, rule number 10, players, for summer rules 2012. Fellas, you have to have a knowledge of yourself and your history. Whatever you are, white, black, Latino, whoever you are, you're going to have a thorough knowledge about yourself and your history, because that's going to help your game. A few listeners, when I did my last show, I had a debate with a white nationalist, and a couple of the players who hit me up on Facebook, they were like, well, Tariq, that show was cool, but we want to, this show is kind of heavy. We just want to get back to the game. We just want to talk about the dating and the relationships. Let's get back on that part of the game and not the history and all that stuff. Let's just get into the Mackin and all that. And the thing is, fellas, when I talk about history, even with Hidden Colors, Hidden Colors is a film that's going to help you step your game up. Understanding your history, understanding who you are historically, that's going to bring a certain level of confidence to you. The thing is, notice some of these niggas out here with all this thirsty bullshit game. These are niggas who don't know who they are. These are niggas who are taught that they were slaves. And when it comes to dating and getting at females, they act like slaves. These niggas act thirsty. They'll take whatever's given to them. They value white women more than anything. These niggas are still slaves out here. So you have to understand who you are historically so you don't have that slave, dusty nigga, thirsty mentality when it comes to spitting at women. You can tell a dude who knows himself because his confidence level is going to be high. Just like a woman. You can tell a woman who has a consciousness about herself. Because she's just going to have a confidence where she's not even trying. She can be natural. She can be low-key and come in the room and radiate. And all the energy will be drawn to that female just because of her vibe. Because she knows who she is. You can tell a woman who don't know who the fuck she is. A woman who has a slave mentality. When you see a female walk up in the spot with 20 tattoos, her ass out, and she got a blonde weave and some blue contact lenses, do you think that motherfucker knows who she is? That motherfucker is asleep. And that game and her energy is going to attract more slave behavior. So it goes for men and women. Understand who you are historically. Because that's definitely going to help your game. That's one of the reasons why I made the Hidden Colors series. Because guys out here, a lot of them were very insecure. Really just in general about who they were. So that's going to help your game. Anyway, y'all, that's been today's episode of the Mack Lessons Radio Show. And again, this Sunday on Ustream, we're working to have a world premiere of the Hidden Colors 2 trailer. Follow me on Twitter at Tariq Nasheed, T-A-R-I-Q, N-A-S-H-E-E-D. and I will keep you posted on if we're definitely going to have it this Sunday on Ustream. But if I were you, I would tune in so you can get that world premiere. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. You guys have a great week. Aloha. 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 Aloha.